Bismillah, alhamdulillah, wassalatu wassalamu ala rasulillah wa ala alihi wa sahbihi ajma'in. Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh. My dear brothers and sisters in Islam, as we live during these beautiful, blessed, incredible days of Dhul Hijjah, the first 10 days, the best days of this world, the most beloved days to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, I wanted to share with you the significance of Dhikrullah, the remembrance of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala during these 10 days of Dhul Hijjah. And Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he says, مَا جَلَسَ قَوْمٌ مَجْلِسًا لَمْ يَذْكُرُ اللَّهَ فِيهِ إِلَّا كَانَ عَلَيْهِمْ تِرَهُ وَمَا مَشَى أَحَدٌ مَمْشًا لَمْ يَذْكُرِ اللَّهَ تَعَالَى فِيهِ إِلَّا كَانَ عَلَيْهِ تِرَهُ وَمَا أَوَى أَحَدٌ إِلَى فِرَاشِهِ لَمْ يَذْكُرِ اللَّهَ تَعَالَى فِيهِ إِلَّا كَانَ عَلَيْهِ تِرَهُ. And Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he says, there is not a gathering of people that gather and do not mention Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala during their gathering, except that their gathering becomes a worry and a regret for them on the day of judgment, and they will be asked about that gathering. When Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he says, there is no one that walks. He walks to the stores, he walks to his work, he walks, he is conducting his daily affairs. And he does not mention Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala during his walk, except that it becomes a tirah upon him. It becomes a worry and a regret, and he will be questioned about it on the day of judgment. When Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam says, and there is no one that goes to bed and does not make mention dhikrullah, he does not make mention of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala before he sleeps, except that it becomes a worry and a regret, and he will be questioned about it on the day of judgment. Subhanallah, when Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he says in the other hadith, he says sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, مَا مِن سَاعَةٍ تَمُرُّ بِابْنِ آدَمْ لَا يَذْكُرِ اللَّهَ تَعَالَى فِيهِ إِلَّا نَدِمَ عَلَيْهَا يَوْمَ الْقِيَامَةِ. That there is not a single hour that passes by al-insan, passes by Bani Adam, in where he does not make mention of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, except that that hour becomes a regret and a worry for him on the day of judgment. My brothers and sisters in Islam, that's one hour that passes by in which you do not engage in dhikrullah, it becomes a regret for you on the day of judgment. If you put these two ahadith together, you learn that Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he's teaching us the purpose in our life. And the purpose in our life is always to remain connected with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala through dhikrullah ta'ala, through the mention of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. My brothers and sisters in Islam, and Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he said, مَثَلُ الَّذِي يَذْكُرِ اللَّهِ وَالَّذِي لَا يَذْكُرُ اللَّهِ كَمَثَلِ الْحَيِّ وَالْمَيِّتِ. And Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he said that the example of the one who makes mention of Allah and he's continuously engaged in dhikrullah, and the one who is not engaged in dhikrullah and abandons dhikrullah, is the example of the dead and the one that is alive. Yani, in other words, Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he made the sign of a living heart and a living person that he remembers Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And the sign of a dead heart and a dead person is the one who abandons and keeps away from dhikrullah subhanahu wa ta'ala. When Allah azza wa jal described the hypocrites in the Quran, he said, وَلَا يَذْكُرُونَ اللَّهَ إِلَّا قَلِيلًا, that they hardly remember Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. They remember Allah, but very little, subhanallah. That is a sign of a hypocrite. Imagine the one that abandons dhikrullah altogether, and he stays away from dhikrullah altogether. What kind of level is this person in the sight of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala? Na'udhu billahi min thalik. My brothers and sisters in Islam, Ramadan was 30 days in which Allah azza wa jal wanted from us to deeply reflect over the ayat of the Quran. Jibreel alayhi salam would revise the Quran with Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam every single Ramadan. Now these 10 days of Dhul Hijjah, Allah azza wa jal wants us to focus on 5 words only. And you need to live with these 5 words. Your heart during these 10 days is supposed to connect with these 5 words. And they're supposed to be observed in your daily life. They're supposed to change your life in these 10 days. These 5 words, my brothers and sisters in Islam. Subhanallah, walhamdulillah, wa la ilaha illallah, والله أكبر ولا حول ولا قوة إلا بالله. الله سبحانه وتعالى, he says in سورة الحج, ويذكر اسم الله في أيام معلومات. Allah Azza wa Jal, he says, he gave us these 10 days so that we make mention of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala's name in these appointed days. Ibn Abbas radiallahu anhu, he says, the appointed days are the 10 days of Dhul Hijjah. In other words, the greatest deed one could do during these days after Al-Hajj is dhikrullah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Being engaged in dhikrullah is higher and the highest deed that one could do during these 10 days, better than anything else you can do in these days. And that is subhanallah, walhamdulillah, wa la ilaha illallah, wallahu akbar. My brothers and sisters in Islam, and Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he specifically instructs and he commands that when the 10 days commence, he says, فَأَكْثِرُوا فِيهِنَّ مِنَ التَّحْمِيدِ وَالتَّهْلِيلِ وَالتَّكْبِيرِ. He says, when the 10 days commence, recite a great deal and recite in the abundance. At-tahleel, la ilaha illallah. At-tahmeed, saying alhamdulillah. At-takbeer, saying Allahu Akbar. My brothers and sisters in Islam, the greatest meeting that ever happened between two human beings was between the two most beloved slaves of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. A meeting between Ibrahim alayhi salam and Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. And this meeting was so grand that it did not happen on earth. It happened in the heavens during the night of Al-Isra wal-Mi'raj. Subhanallah, such a meeting, such a huge meeting. What would you think that they both discussed? What was the topic that they both discussed? They did not discuss politics, nor did they discuss the economical crisis on earth. Nor did they discuss future plans for this earth. Ibrahim alayhi salam meets in Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, a historical meeting that will never take place ever again until the day of judgment. Ibrahim alayhi salam, he says to Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, recite my salam to your ummah and say to them that al-jannah qi'an, that the paradise is vast and spacious and leveled in its land, and that it is pure soil, and that there is pure, fresh, delicious water within. And then he said, O Muhammad, inform your people and tell them, أَنَّ غِرَاسَهَا سُبْحَانَ اللَّهُ وَالْحَمْدُ لِلَّهِ وَلَا إِلَهَ إِلَّا اللَّهُ وَاللَّهُ أَكْبَرُ وَلَا حَوْلَ وَلَا قُوَّةَ إِلَّا بِاللَّهِ. Teach them and inform them that the seeds in the paradise, the way you plant your property in the paradise is with these five words. Allahu Akbar, Subhanallah. My brothers and sisters in Islam, a person these days, he struggles ye and ye and ye of his life just to purchase a land on earth. And then it takes him years to build and construct something on it. When Nabi sallallahu alayhi wasallam is teaching us in this hadith that the way you plant a seed is by saying subhanallah. The way you build your house and you build your property in the paradise, look how easy it is. In an instant, you're building a kingdom for yourself with the word subhanallah, walhamdulillah, wa la ilaha illallah, wallahu akbar. That's why, my brothers and sisters in Islam, the one who does not make mention of Allah, the one who does not have dhikrullah on his tongue frequently, he is considered min al-ghafilin. He's counted from among the heedless. Why is he counted from among the heedless? Because look how easy this reward is. That you earned a tree in the paradise by saying subhanallah, and you knew that and you still neglected and abandoned it. Therefore, you are min al-ghafilin, from among the heedless. May Allah Azza wa Jal protect us from heedlessness. My brothers and sisters in Islam, these five words, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala loves them. Ahabbu al-kalami ilallah. Allah loves these words. And these are words that Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, that they are ahabbu ilayya mimma tala'at alayhi al-shams. That these words, subhanallah, walhamdulillah, wa la ilaha illallah, wallahu akbar, wa la hawla wa la quwwata illa billah, are more beloved to Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam than this world and everything that is within this world. You know why? Because this world and everything in it is only temporary. At the end, it'll all be destroyed and washed away and gone, and it'll not follow you to the hereafter. Whereas one word, subhanallah, You will see it on the day of judgment. It'll follow you to your grave. It'll come out with you after you come out from the grave. And it'll keep following you until it is placed on the scale on the day of judgment. وسبحانالله وبحمده النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم says, تملأ الميزان الله أكبر. It fills the scale when you're worried and the deeds are being placed on the scale and your bad deeds are weighing down and they've become heavy. Subhanallah comes and it's placed on the other part of the scale and it will outweigh the good. And as a result, Allah Azza wa Jal admits such a person in the paradise. My brothers and sisters in Islam, let's understand that As-Salaf Rahimahumullah, they used to say that we used to feel tremendous moments of happiness and joy in this life when we used to make dhikrullah and we used to engage in dhikrullah. They used to say, we used to feel so much happiness and joy and tranquility with dhikrullah to the point where we said, if the people of the paradise are enjoying what we are enjoying on earth, then the people of the paradise are in a huge blessing of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Subhanallah, my brothers and sisters in Islam, there are believers in this world that reach this level in where they wish that in the paradise they experience similar to that which they experienced in this life of peace and tranquility because of dhikrullah subhanahu wa ta'ala. This is why Shaykh al-Islam ibn Taymiyyah rahimahullah, he said, إِنَّ فِي الدُّنْيَا جَنَّةً مَنْ لَمْ يَدْخُلْهَا لَمْ يَدْخُلْ جَنَّةَ الْآخِرَةِ. That in this worldly life there is a paradise. Who does not enter this paradise, then he does not enter the paradise of the hereafter. Allahu Akbar. And the paradise of this world is the peace and the tranquility one enjoys. And that can only be attained through dhikrullah. As Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, أَلَا بِذِكْرِ اللَّهِ تَطْمَئِنُّ الْقُلُوبِ. It is only by dhikrullah, by the mention of Allah, in which the hearts find peace, tranquility and rest. My brothers and sisters in Islam, yani the purpose of this video was that I warn you of the severity that you are in if you abandon dhikrullah subhanahu wa ta'ala. What a loss and what a waste of life if you lived it without dhikrullah on your tongue continuously and consistently. And these 10 days are a moment in which we're supposed to increase in dhikrullah so that the heart finds relief and finds love of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and reconnects with Allah tabaraka wa ta'ala. And Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam says, الدنيا ملعونة ملعون ما فيها إلا ذكر الله وما والاه وعالما ومتعلما. And Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he says that this worldly life is cursed and everything in it is cursed except dhikrullah. Except dhikrullah and anything that is similar to dhikrullah and a scholar, a teacher and a student. So my brothers and sisters in Islam, don't waste your time running around that which is cursed. Don't waste your time in that which is cursed. Subhanallah, walhamdulillah, wa la ilaha illallah, wallahu akbar. Keep these words on your tongue, especially during these 10 days. And that is the best deed that you could engage in these 10 days after the deed of Al-Hajj. We ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to accept from us and to be pleased with us. And we ask Him subhanahu wa ta'ala that He gives us this enjoyment and He gives us this happiness and this joy and this peace and this tranquility that is found with dhikrullah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Jazakum Allahu khayra. وصلى الله وسلم وبارك على نبينا محمد وعلى آله وصحبه أجمعين.